Assalamualaikum. Roll number 191016. This is our task of interfacing LCD. So first we will go towards our main this header file lcd.h, in which we have defined fcpu. These commands are used for this header file, that is for delay commands. And then inside LCD we have control pins and data pins. So inside these control pins we have given to enable that it will be controlled by PB0, PB1 and PB2. RS will be controlled by PB1 and RW will be controlled by PB2. These are the pins of the port B. And then we have made functions, so let's discuss that. Inside LCD command we have and its return data type is unsigned character command. So inside port D, enable pin will be shifted left for 1 bit, and RS and RW will be remained unshifted. Then inside port C, we will, that will be equal to our return type, that is command. And then we have made a delay. And then inside port B, in nothing of these control pins will be they will remain unshifted. Then we will move towards our next function, that is LCD init, and its return data type is void. That will that means that it will return nothing. And then we have used the above function LCD command here with this value 0x30, then a delay of 10 milliseconds, then LCD, and then a function with value 0x01, and again a 10 milliseconds, then 0x0e, 0x80, and so on, and until we want our solution. Then the next function is void LCD data. Return data type is unsigned character data of the variable used. So basically this is our return data type, that it will return void, means nothing or empty. So inside port B we have shifted enable and RS towards left side with 1 bit each, and RW will remain unshifted, and port C will be equal to, and we have inserted the data inside port C. We have used a delay, and inside port B the enable will remain unshifted and RS will be shifted left with 1 bit. And then inside void LCD string we have used a for loop in which the string will not be equal to a string will run until the value is unless the value is this /0, and it will continue to run until this condition is reached. And inside then we have used the above this function in that in which the string or the data we want to write. Then these are two commands of LCD shift left or LCD shift right, that is same as we did in our LCD string, but here we have used LCD command, that the command will be run and the value of this will be this port this pin of port C, I guess. So here in LCD shift left we have LCD command, and inside LCD shift right we will use 0x1c here. So that was our header file. We will continue our code towards main. Inside main we have defined our header files according to the AVR C programming and delays, and we have included this header file. And then inside int main we have given we have set the direction of port B as 0x07 and port C as 0xff. Then inside LCD init we have first called our function that we have made inside this header file. So first we have called the command LCD init, and inside LCD init we can see here the LCD command function was being called, and then we have named we have used an unsigned character named string, and we have written the data inside that, as we knew that inside string the it was used as LCD data string. That means if any string is written here, for example these are our groups roll number, mine is 191016, the next are 180866 and 191037. So this string will be written inside LCD data, and that was being called inside LCD write string. And LCD string and this value will be stored, then the LCD will shift to left and LCD will shift towards right with the value of decimal 16. I have already debugged, so we will continue towards our Proteus. Inside this @mega, we will upload our hex file that was made in, and that is in the folder of Atmel Studios. And this is our LCD, a 16x2 LCD, and this is our VSS which is connected towards the ground. And VSS will be connected towards ground, and this is our potentiometer that will set which will increase or decrease the speed of the solution or the data that is being written on this LCD. So I have set it towards 100%, and its value is 1K. So, and its output is being attached towards VEE, and VDD is attached to our input, and this input of potentiometer. And RS, as we said earlier, that enable was connected towards PB0, and its value, and its it is the pin 1052 is attached with RS as PB1 and PB2, or 1051 is attached towards RW. And these D0 up to D7 is connected towards our from our port C. These are all pins of our port C. So when we will start our simulation, that is this. So we can see here that our data is being written on this LCD using the functions named LCD string or LCD data. Here we can see the LCD is being shifted towards right, and then it will shift towards left. Here we can see it is again shifting towards left. And next the video will be presented of hardware of this LCD interfacing. Thank you. So as I have shown earlier that this was our output in our Proteus simulation. So now that's our hardware, and you can see here.
When we rotate this knob, we can see the difference.
Basically, here we can see that these three pins are our control pins, and these three pins are our control pins, these are our VSS, VDD, VEE, and the rest are the data pins, and this is our data displayed. Due to the display function in which we have written our data, stored our data, and this was our task 4, and through this potentiometer we can see that we can display our information on LCD. So that was our lab 4 LCD interfacing.